In Times Square, Aaron is sat on the stone with Mika. Mika throws the freeze-dried Skittles to him as he tries to catch them in his mouth. He catches one. Finally, they laugh. Stop him! They look to see a woman in a leather jacket with ACE branded across the back of it. People gasp. Come back! The woman jumps on the man. He falls. You got something I want. Give it to me, or else. Take it! She puts her hands into Zaranite's pockets and pulls out a yellow and brown spherical object. Oh yeah, and Ace presses a button on Zaranite's wrist. He morphs into a yellow, gloopy alien. People begin to scream and run. Oh my god. He's an alien. Go home. You don't need to see this. But he's an alien, yeah? Go home. Come on, Mika. Entire city is in mass hysteria. We should go back to mine. It's safe. This is only going to cause riots. She's right. Come on. No. She knows what's happening, and I want in. Fine. She sighs. There's an alien spacecraft above New York, and no one can see it because they're draining power from the Hudson Yards. The power cuts. Exactly. My friend and I, we deal with this kind of stuff everywhere we go. She takes out a walkie-talkie. Professor, I've taken him some strays whilst catching Zaranite. She puts it in her pocket. You better come with me. In an alleyway, Ace presents a wooden blue box to Mika and Aaron. A wooden box? The police? I'm not trusting you. It's just a disguise for our office. She opens the door and steps inside. Aaron and Mika follow. Inside, they are presented with a white room with circular symbols on the walls and a hexagonic shape in the middle of the room. The three of them watch as an old man in a cream blazer and hat flicks switches on a console. Interesting, very interesting indeed. Ace hangs her jacket up on a coat hanger. I got it. She hands a spherical object to him. Ah, perfect. He puts it in a beaker and places it on a flat surface on the toilet console. Well, if we give it a few minutes, it should be able to give us an exact location of the Zorellian spacecraft. He looks at Aaron and Mika. Looks at Ace, and then looks back at Aaron and Mika. I believe we haven't been introduced. Aaron and Mika stare at him in pure confusion. I didn't catch their names. Mika. Aaron. I'm a doctor. How do you do? I'm fine. I just want to know what the hell is happening in my city. Is it really aliens? I'm afraid so. The TARDIS console bleeps. Ah! Got the coordinates? Yep. So we all go to the ship. No. You and Mika stay here and keep an eye on things. Anne? If you'd like to come with me. Okay. You'll be okay, won't you? Yeah. Will you? Yeah. They hug. Come on. Ace and Mika leave the TARDIS. In the alleyway, they watch as the TARDIS dematerializes. Is that a spaceship?
Yeah, it travels in time too.
No way. Yeah, I've been to loads of places. Like World War II. An old house I burnt down on my own time. Met Florence Nightingale locked up in Calder's Castle. Been through her then.
Yeah, you could say that.
How much trouble is my city in?
You really want to know?
Mika gulps. Please. A lot. She looks down. In the TARDIS, Aaron is still amused by the room he has stepped into.
So, what do these Zorellians want?
Ah, that's the problem. We don't exactly know of yet. Maybe they just want to survive. Maybe that's why they're stealing energy from the Hudson.
Very good.
I have a feeling it's much worse than that. How much worse? Catastrophic. On the Zorallian ship, TARDIS materializes. In a greenish room with wires and yellow lighting and scientific equipment spread out across the room. The Doctor and Aaron exit the TARDIS. Hands in the air. Soraya, we meet again. You will not stop us, Doctor. And why is that? Because you're too late. Too late for what? Judgment Day for the Zorallian Empire. What? The energy surging from the Hudson Yards. That is only a mere screw in our plan, Doctor. What are you talking about? What's going on? I don't know. Think, Doctor. Because everything is Primitive's news stories. The energy surges, the reports of lights in the sky. The missing persons case. Missing persons cases? Zorara smiles. Doctor, you really are stupid. What's she talking about, Doctor? Doctor, I don't know. Zorara presses a button, revealing the test tube with a human inside probed up with wires and machinery. Oh my god. He gags. No. Yes. No. Yes. You're using people to generate more energy for your ship. Zorara laughs. Finally, he gets it. Where are the rest of them? Here. She walks over to the window overlooking New York. The Doctor and Aaron follow her. She flicks a switch. No! In Times Square, a humming noise is made. What's that? Ace and Mika look up. Oh my god. People begin to scream as unconscious people float in the air.